This is Chris Dahlia, and today I will be reading this Monte Cristo's book. So this is a hands-on guide to managing your emotional well-being with crystals. Crystals are here as escorts, facilitating a higher knowledge of and connection to our planet. It's a self-care tool, speaking the same language. Through science, there is an understanding that all matter, even if it appears to be solid, is actually vibratory in nature. It means that the human body is moving back and forth in motion at all times, as is the crystal on your desk. Everything seemingly solid vibrates at various frequencies. The energetic signature emitted by wavelengths of electromagnetic energy. Healing in action. Healing may be experienced due to applying slower and deliver sound to crystals open up access to intuition and help us to recognize repeated patterns and shift outdated ones. Crystals possess the ability to teach us how to maintain, alter, or enhance emotional states. Crystal combinations. As crystal resonance therapists explore now gemstone stories together for our professional collaboration, we tend to first work with single crystals as a way to get to know them well, vibrationally. Then we incorporate powerful crystal combinations to enhance the experience. Working with crystals. Crystal healing can be subtle or profound. It can come through quickly or take many cycles of sitting with the stone consciousness to gain awareness of the way it is working on or resonating with you. The information can come through in a variety of different ways, and it's not always instant. Exercises will help facilitate a deeper understanding of each crystal's energy, how to collaborate with them to support your mood, personal goals, creation, and dreams, and enhance overall self-care. Choosing a stone. Now that we have understanding of effective crystal healing, it's time to explore the crystal or mineral you're looking to work with. Sometimes you know the law of motion. Some human beings do not want to understand our picture. Take back to the one and it's not only clarity or direction to help you to start. The emotion use questionnaire at the end of the book. Stop question. Questionnaire that helps to choose the right crystal for you, and it has to do with your emotions. Do you detect your feelings in your physical body? Smoke bath. Develop focus on your intention to relax, sit, and connect with your stone. Hold the stone in your hand and place that hand over your heart. As you take several deep breaths, make an intention to open yourself up to receptivity, to commune with and receive the message of the crystal. You can specifically align to an emotional intention or open yourself up to whatever comes through. To begin the meditation, take a few deep breaths and close your eyes. Visualize a landscape near a body of water. Go through the process of physically connecting with the water. Scan your body all the way up to the throat area. Take a breath to full surrender and let go. When you feel ready, visualize yourself safely and fully submerged in the gentle water up to the crown of your head. Begin to touch or gently rub the stone in your hand to signal awareness and connection. Through your breath, sense the essence of the stone. Begin to gently usher through your being. Spend as much time as you like here. In your mind's eye, when you are ready, visualize yourself walking forward out of the water. Crystal in hand and acknowledgement in your heart for the time spent together communicating with the stone. Take several deep inhalations and audibly sigh, exhalation out of your body in all directions. When you're ready, open your eyes and return back. You can journal experiences. How do you feel right now? Did you feel the stone pulsating in a specific area of your body? Did you notice any shifts in your being from before and after the practice? Did you experience any thoughts, feelings, or sensations? These reflections will become valuable to you over the long term of your crystal relationship. Guided core meditation. Also, let's do with water. This one is quite similar. You wish to attain. It goes hand in hand with the age-old saying, stop and smell the roses, or in this case, stop and touch your crystal for an express energetic tune-up. The practice. You can do this while sitting, standing in line, working, or anytime you have a few moments to spare. Hold the stone in your hand with the option to bring your hand over your heart while inhaling. Exhaling deeply. You are simply tuning or checking in with the stone, getting a baseline of its energy. Take note again that this purposeful connection is being established by you with the stone's own hands. Maintain or alter your current emotional state. The crystal's energy becomes more powerful because you are checking in with the energy the stone is offering. This alternative, light and some more comfortable. Period, calendar, copper, and coin. stone combination, ruby and sapphire, diamond and emerald, turquoise and obsidian. Were they blue or green tourmaline, emerald, lepidolite, and larimar? Stone combinations, ruby and zeolite, tourmaline and lepidolite, larimar and lepidolite. So we have tourmaline, green tourmaline, calm, rose quartz, larimar, lepidolite, watermelon tourmaline. Combinations, rose quartz and larimar, lepidolite and watermelon tourmaline. Playful, carnelian, faith and quartz, green calcite, lemurian seed crystal. Stone combinations, lemurian seed crystal and selenite, faded quartz and labradorite, green calcite and carnelian. Optimistic, fluorite, kyanite, sunstone, amazonite. Here we have fluorite and powerful stone combination. Sunstone and golden apatite. Accepting, amethyst, hedonite, heliodor, conzite. Yes, amethyst. And stone combinations, conzite and hedonite, heliodor and citrine. Leodor and rhodochrosite. Board, orange calcite, calcite, correct me if I pronounce it wrong, calcite, yes, orange calcite, Iceland spar, stone combinations, orange calcite and Iceland spar, fulgurite and smoky quartz, fluorite and quartz, worn out, citrine, ruby, gold and phenolite. So yeah, citrine and calcite. Begin with letter C. So, combinations, ruby and gold, citrine and ruby, gold and moldavite. Fearful, tamborite, fluorite, seraphinite, and green calcite. Green calcite and fluorite, seraphinite, kyanite and labradorite, kyanite, tamborite, looks similar to quartz. Lonely, cherite, copper, elastal quartz, epidote, stone. Tiger's eye and turquoise, citrine and sapphire. Here we have citrine. Confident, ruby, black tourmaline, galena, and rainbow obsidian. Here there is ruby. Chrysocolla, my favorite, and Diopterus as well. It's very beautiful color, this green and blue color, and ruby. Here we have copper, angry, black tourmaline, larimar, kunzite. Obsidian and sunstone, blue apatite, possessive, tiger's eye, blue kyanite, stalbite, and sugalite. Thank you. calcite, rubellite, tourmaline, rubellite, rose quartz. Empathetic, hemimorphite, chrysanthemum stone. Chrysanthemum stone, lepidolite, blissful, moonstone, green jade, ocean jasper. Discouraged, wolfenite, tiger's eye, fading quartz, selenite, wolfenite, sorrowful, amber, celestine. Enlighten. Tears. That's obsidian. Chrysocolla. Andalusite. Bloodstone. It's dark green with orange and red, usually red, but some orange as well. Lazuli. Anxious. Snowflake obsidian.